Hello there, dear ones. This is Mandian Astral Oracles coming to you from rural continental Denmark. I'm in some of the easternmost parts of the Jutland Peninsula. Actually, since some of you have asked, if you look at the Jutland Peninsula, which is juts out on top of Germany. To the north of Germany, on top of Europe, and then on the eastern part of this, if you look at it as if it was a little man, then his nose is a peninsula called the Djursland Peninsula, to the east, and from that nose trickles like some peninsulas or the snot of this nose, and I'm on the southernmost tip of the snot, so on a peninsula jutting out on another peninsula, and where I'm that is called Helioness, so which means something like Hallowed Peninsula. It's one of these Scandinavian words we have a lot of about like formations of soil or rock jutting out into the water. So that's where I'm at, and I'm out here enjoying the spring, even though it's a great day. It's also a mild one, and I'm accompanied by Martha the dog, one of my favorite beings in the whole world. So I hope you're well out there. I'm going to channel Archangel Gabriel, I believe it will be this day, about receiving love, and it's a theme that's coming up for me, and it appears to be something that's present for a lot of people, this thing about also new opportunities showing themselves and life actually presenting itself from, well, perhaps a more uncertain angle, but also a more promising angle and a more rewarding angle, and actually being in a place where to some extent the hurt is behind you, and you're receiving love from, well, unexpected and untold places, and actually allowing yourself to take in this energy and let it transform you. So I think it will be interesting to see what he has to say about it, and like love is everywhere. As I sat down here, like these dead branches, they even had these small shiitake-like mushrooms we call the ears of Judas on them. So like even in the cold Danish spring, there's prosperity abounds in nature. So lovely to have you here, guys. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy the message. Yes, our blessings and love from the heavens. Hallowed is this rock. Hallowed are these branches. Hallowed are the fungus that grows on them. Hallowed is this grass. Hallowed is this place. Hallowed is this air. Hallowed is this time. Hallowed is this voice. Hallowed is this moment. There is much bounty for you being extended from the heavens. It is an oft repeated saying that nature spills over with love for humanity, and it is worth taking heed of the fact that you are beloved and you are shown a bounty of sensory experience. All the time, you are shown often a bounty of sustenance, of information, of emotional output or input, however you may see it, of happenings, changes, uncertainties and circumstances that may seem insurmountable but only present themselves as challenges, it is worth having something to compete against, even if what you're competing against is your own ability to love. That is to say, it's worth having a goal that you set out for yourself. And it is a noble goal to be able to receive the love that you are capable of seeing and experiencing in the world. So what has taken place for many of you, the people we have often termed light workers, have given other titles, those of the light who align themselves with source and their inner mission, their higher calling and their call to servitude to the divine. Well, these people, they often find themselves in situations that are lacking in love, care and warmth. Well, partially because they seek out situations where they are able to cultivate these things. And so much as the healer seeks out sickness to heal, then the light worker seeks out darkness to illuminate. That is a natural tendency. But the difficult point here is, of course, that the person who identifies as a source of light, well, they also become identified with a stream of continual giving from their energetic bodies. And this is not sustainable. You need to sometimes turn off the light to allow yourself to recharge the batteries. There is a bounty being extended from nature that recharges you. And by nature we mean all that is created, given to you in the moment, all that is brought forward without your concerted effort, without your concern, without your attempts, without your worries, and without your attachments. That is most of your experience. That is the, let us say, unconscious part of your manifestation. It is, of course, not unconscious because it is something that's accessible for you to experience, meaning it's directly accessible to consciousness. But what it means is that you have it in a type of storage space. It is not something you interact with or concern you with. It is something that's established as immediate surrounding, as environment, you could call it. And notice how rich your environment is. Notice how there is not only the effort of you, not only the effort of the people surrounding you, not only the effort of the people surrounding them and society at large, accumulated into wealth, into edibles, into housing, into places of worship, places of civic function, places of entertainment. All of these are essentially human achievements that demonstrates a bounty created by creative spirit acting through humanity. But also there is an accumulation of all the people that have gone before you, all the wealth and all the things that they have left behind, all the trash as well, but it is your both ability and task as someone set in time to turn this trash into treasures, to find purposes for it, or to find storage spaces where it can disintegrate and again merge with dust into the wind of the planet and there spread its life force and its nourishment to new growths and outcroppings. This is the cycle of life, and you know it well, but you are often extracted from it by immediate concerns. And so the best thing you can do when trying to receive this love is to register that love is already around you. It is already created, presented to you exactly in the moment, in this eternal unwrapping of the present that you have created for yourself. There is a bounty. And so when you turn off your light, that is to say, when you cease giving for a moment, it becomes more vivid for you. And there, allow yourself to really take it in, to really experience it, to really submerge yourself in the gift of life, the ooze of energy that is this planet and the manifold creations that inhabit it, to allow yourself to connect to the tethers that bind you here, the loving strings that hold you together with other loving beings, the things that make it valuable for you to stay on this planet and in this frame of time and space, rather than to merge back into the realm of the angels. Look for these reasons. They are all around you, and you are allowed to identify with them. You're allowed to go into these places and to discover where it is that, well, there is darkness within you that leads illumination from without. And when you discover this darkness and you discover the source of light that is shining all around you, that is verily, truthfully, you in a higher form, a form that is non-localized, a form that is creative, a form that is ceaseless in its bringing forward of creation, of mystery, of challenge, of game, of love. These are things that creation, external reality as you call it, bring forward to you. And you need to drop whatever you are clinging to and are holding in your hands to receive the thing that reality is rewarding you with. And do not be afraid to use your rewards. Do not be afraid to spend your gifts. Do not be afraid to let your talents work for you in the world, because they were given to you for the same purpose. And as tools were created, so they were meant to create other things. They have their purpose in bringing forward things, in being mediums for untold forces greater than them coming through them. This is the essence of the media. This is you in the middle as a conduit for love. And as soon as you allow yourself to receive, you allow greater love to flow through you. There is no true giving without receiving. There is no receiving without giving. But one cannot fulfill one energetic purpose or blueprint alone in this lifetime. That is not the role for human beings to fulfill. And so therefore, you would rather connect with these manifold energies. You would rather also play the receiver to the light and see how much light grows within you and allows you to expand and touch upon dark corners, crevices, where other gifts, other presence are hiding within you, becoming more illuminated, turning into a grander temple for love. That is your being expanding into a vibration of love by allowing itself to receive the light and to transform it within, to hold it, and to then pass it on in new shapes, edified, beautified, blessed. All this energy, all the love that you receive, it becomes constructed into other higher visions. Know that you are an instrument for the divine in this. Whatever you do, you are an instrument for the divine. But when you sense the feeling of joy, creation, purpose, excitement, that is when you align with the divine source. That is when you and God become one in the breath that you are both exhaling into the world, and by that giving life for the greater world to create the oxygen for your next inhale. You are the woods, you are the oceans, you are the stars eternal, and you are a human being put here expressing wonder, being wonder, loving wonder, wondering about love. Therefore, receive this loving transmission and the blessings and benedictions of the heavens. A wonder it has been to be with you, dear humans. May you be well this day. Goodbye.